On completing this chapter, you will have an understanding of how the next voyage order decides the tanker operations in the ballast voyage, why cargo tank inspections are required routinely in ballast voyages, why crude oil washing machines need to be tested for functionality regularly, why ballast voyages are suitable for the most critical tanker operations in terms of safety of personnel, the function of the ODME, and why it is to be constantly switched on, whether being used or not. How does the next voyage order decide a crude oil tanker's operational activity as soon as she is free of cargo? The voyage order is normally received from the owner or charterer as soon as possible after she is free of her previous cargo. In any event, the vessel's next destination port, either for loading or for awaiting orders, has to be instructed to the master. In all cases, it is received prior to arriving at the next loading port in order to ensure sufficient quantity of bunker oil for the laden voyage. If the discharge port is not known prior to departure from the loading port, the consequence may be extra quantity of bunker oil in stock, which may reduce the cargo intake, or the vessel may have to call at a port for bunkers during the voyage. Depending on the duration of the voyage to the loading port, maintenance and ballast change activities can be undertaken. Why are cargo tanks required to be inspected internally in ballast voyages? Reduced thickness of high tensile steel in modern double hull tankers can cause corrosion holes or pitting and oil leaks into ballast tanks and from there overboard. Also to be considered are metal fatigue and stress that threaten the integrity of the hull structure. Classification societies such as Lloyd's or DNV certify that ships are in class for insurance companies who otherwise will not let the owners buy insurance policies from them for the hull and machinery. Depending on the treatment and trade, the frequency of cargo tank inspection is therefore an agreement between the shipping company and the classification society. How often are cargo tank inspections required? The company's PMS, which is approved by the class, defines the frequency of cargo tank inspections. For some companies, the policy is to have all cargo tanks inspected within a 24-month period. For oil tankers, inspection of cargo tanks should be made at intervals not exceeding 2.5 years. Ballast tanks are to be inspected annually. After how many usages must each crude oil washing machine be tested for correct functioning as required by the PMS for MARPOL and Classification Society requirement? The MARPOL regulations require fixed tank equipment, like deck-mounted and submerged crude oil washing machines, to be regularly inspected for functionality and maintenance. This function check shall be performed after 6 usages of the machine, but the interval of checks shall not exceed 12 months. When does this testing require water washing of the tank, even in new double hull tankers? It is acceptable to verify the function of submerged tank washing machines from outside of the tank, either by a rotation indicator or by observing the impact sound when the machine is working. The deck-mounted crude oil washing machines can easily be lifted out of the tank for inspection and testing. The new generation of double-hull crude oil tankers have by design achieved smooth and plain bulkheads in the cargo tanks. The majority of longitudinal webs and stiffeners have been moved to the double-hull side of the longitudinal bulkheads, thus reducing the number of protrusions and constructions which made it difficult to clean the tank earlier. In order to achieve the cleaning coverage required by MARPOL, the new generation of crude oil tankers will still have to fit submerged crude oil washing machines. For instance, to cover undersides of stringer decks, either in the fore or after part of the tank and in the slop tanks. Where the function cannot be verified from outside of the tank must be water washed, gas freed, and the machines be inspected from inside of the tank while they are working with water pressure. Each occasion of testing of the crude oil washing machines must be recorded in Supplement 2 of the Oil Record Book. For detailed information on inspection and maintenance of crude oil washing machines, see CBT number 0054. Why is the ballast voyage suitable for the most critical operation in a crude oil tanker in terms of safety of personnel? The ballast voyage is normally the most suitable time to carry out maintenance on the vessel's cargo equipment. After a discharge with crude oil washing, there will always be need for repairs and overhaul of equipment used. The vessel's PMS contains full details on each individual instrument or piece of equipment, like the manufacturer's recommended maintenance schedule, periodic overhaul, history, etc. If a cargo tank needs to be water washed and gas freed in order to check submerged crude oil washing machines and for internal tank inspection, this will involve both the pumpman and bosun with deck crew. Gas freeing and entering a cargo tank is the most critical operation on a crude oil tanker. What is the function of the oil discharge monitoring and control system in a ballast voyage? The ODME is a system used on ballast voyages to ensure that no oil is discharged into the sea when draining out water collected on board during cargo tank washing. The oily water is allowed to first settle in a slop tank where the oil separates out above the clean water, which is then monitored carefully while being pumped into the sea. The ODME is a complicated instrument that consists of some four systems. The oil content meter that measures oil in the water stream by ppm. The flow meter measures flow rate of oily water through the discharge pipe. The monitoring and controlling computer that calculates oil discharge rate in liters per nautical mile, total quantity, together with date and time identification. The three-way overboard valve control system that enables to stop the discharge when the permissible limit has been reached. The latest models of ODME have become very advanced and require little maintenance by the vessel's crew. The maintenance is limited to changing the printer paper, roll and ink. Why is the ODME required to be switched on at all times, whether draining out slops or not? The oil content meter sensors and the flow meter are permanently connected to the overboard discharge system piping and valves, and must continuously monitor that no illegal oily discharge has taken place deliberately or inadvertently at any time from an oil tanker. The ODME shall at all times be switched on. And when not in operating mode, it must be switched to standby modus, as it automatically carries out calibration and cleaning operation. The printer paper rolls must be stored on board. Retention time, 3 years. All service and maintenance work on the system is to be recorded in the oil record book. For detailed information on ODME, see CBT number 0055.